The dream. to be. The world designed and planned by one who came to be known as Yahweh. God called Abraham to be our father in faith. God spoke to him first, and he became the father of Israel. Then God called Moses. Now Moses was an orphan, abandoned years ago as a baby. One day while wandering in the wilderness around Mount Sinai, he came upon a burning bush. A voice came from the flames. I am the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Moses began to tremble and didn't dare to look. Then the Lord said to him, take off the sandals from your feet, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. I have surely seen the mistreatment of my people who are in Egypt, and have heard their groaning, and have come down to rescue them. Come now, I will send you to Egypt.
Worshipped them. The prophets call on the people.
visit the people. Repent, for the time is near. And so, in the fullness of time, God came to the children of Israel, indeed to all people, as a child, to live among the people, born out of love. Here begins the story.
Heaven this be, since I do not know a man. The angel said to her,
by God. His name, John. He came from the desert, shouting aloud, "Prepare! Prepare the way of the Lord!
Prepare the way of the Lord! Turn away from injustice, oppression, hatred, fear, for there is one coming after me who will throw the mighty from their seats. He will raise the lowly. He will tell of many good things. But listen to him. Come now, be washed all over in the waters of new life. I baptize with water, but the one who comes after me, he will baptize with fire.
My name is Judith.
Peace of God be with you.
I am Ruth, and I believe in what you say.
Ruth, be washed clean.
Daniel of Nazareth, I am lost to seek the man of whom you speak.
Do you remember when life began, the waters splashed the world with light? And it was good, yes, it was so good that God created you to burn. And we have turned away from our God and must return to the Creator's heart. There is one greater than I to show the way to the heart of God. Now I'm standing upon you, come to me, the ways of your life.
one baptizing with water, this voice crying in the wilderness upset many powerful people who wanted to see his destruction. They had him arrested and held in a cold, dark cell.
Was it always your time, John the Baptist? Will any of your followers be brave enough to continue the work you began? Who will be stupid enough to follow this man, Jesus? You are just a fool, John.
Yeah, just a fool.
For God's sake.
Save me now, free me now. I am a fool.
He grew weary from his journey, and he came and sat here at Jacob's well. As he rested here, a Samaritan woman came to draw some water.
Please, could you get me some water?
Why would you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink?
You do not know who I am. If you did, you would ask me in return for the gift of living water.
Sir, this is a very deep well. How do you expect to get this living water when you don't have a bucket? Perhaps you think yourself greater than our ancestor Jacob, who has given us this well.
Oh.
Perhaps you could tell me something I've never understood. Why is it they say the only place we must worship is Jerusalem?
Why do we worry about such things? Look at me. The time is coming when we will have to realize that we will not worship God as in the past. We will have to learn to love God in a new and more loving way, with our whole being, in spirit and in truth.
Many people say that the time is here, and that the Messiah is coming. It is said that when he does come, he will tell us of many good things.
I am the one of whom you speak.
The woman left her water jar and returned to the city, telling everyone she met to come and meet this man who had told her everything she had done. She began to wonder whether this man called Jesus could really be the Messiah that she and so many people longed for. Many came to believe in Jesus because of the woman's testimony, and the disciples stayed there for 2 days.
I have left.
Jesus had made many friends during his travels around the countryside of Judea. Not least among these was Lazarus, who lived at Bethany with his two sisters, Mary and Martha. Now, news came to Jesus while he was still some distance from Bethany that Lazarus, the one whom he loved, was gravely ill. Jesus, however, did not seem upset by this. And this puzzled his friends.
Thank you.
Paul was at hand, and a great crowd of people were coming to Jerusalem for the celebrations. Jesus was going to be there as well. They came out bearing branches of palm trees, and waving them before him, cried out, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." And so Jesus entered Jerusalem. The authorities, however, were not impressed.
Thank you. And now, my friends, it's time to tell you that I must suffer and die, but rise again to new life. You now can see me, but soon you will not. To your eyes I will be gone, but in your hearts, there I will live. Can you touch the life inside you? Like a jar full and flowing over. A spring filled with hope. Remember all that I have taught you. Show now the world that love is the only law, the greatest of all commandments. A love that brings forth justice, mercy, forgiveness, and hope. You soon will be scattered like seeds on the wind. But do not lose heart, for I will be there breathing the spirit into your lives, as God did when the ages began. Thank you.
Take this, my friends, this is my body. Broken and shed for you. This bread is for the life of the world, to be given to all who hunger.
But we can fry it up.
those who said they would follow him to the end. Alone and beaten, bruised and rejected, they thrust a cross upon his back. They laughed at him. They spat at him where once they had sung a hosanna to the king. Golgotha, the place of the skull. Up a steep hill where he would hang with two others. They were not kings, just lost souls, seeking answers to questions not yet asked. Fitting companions for the one who had loved. A woman came to him and wiped sweat from his forehead. He said, "Weep not for me, woman. Women, weep for your children. For I am going to my father, but you are here. Soon, perhaps, you will understand what all this madness is about."
early on the morning of the third day. The stone was removed, but he was not there. A voice came from behind her.
Why look here, woman of God, for the living? For this is a place for the dead.
He has been taken away. I have come to visit the one I loved. He was a man and king, yet they put him to death. He was different, but so like us all. In the end, we didn't understand. For he spoke about this day as if he knew not death. Yes, he said strange things.
Oh, my God.
And if you get the balance right, the white, you know, it's going to be a lot brighter in the background white, you know.
She wants us just to have, like, large sheets on, like, you know.
Huh?
Last night it was chaotic, having them back where they are, because it's also unfair to let the dancers were on and people scattered there.
Nobody can be sitting there. Levi Leonard. They're the only ones bringing me a tent and saying, oh, no, don't be anything to me. I promise, I'm just checking the time. I'll be there. But the winner, who is really someone who has been eager this year and their first year in the show, and I think they are super for really putting in the effort, and that's Christopher Noonan. The first nominee is Colin Summers for Pilot. Shane Roach for the half step. Eamon Leonard for Will It or Will It Won't Be Singing in the Rain. The full orchestra for Act Two. Joe Gagan for his signing up with the attitude. Yes. There's only one person who I know knows the language off by heart, and that is Caroline Keogh. Award doesn't come for tomorrow. I feel this year that the general award should go to Louise Clement. The last award for tonight, there is one tomorrow, but the last award tonight is the most impressive person that I have seen that's been with us for a long time, but has made an impression on me this year, and that is Siobhan Somerville. Yay!
This has been a wonderful experience for me, working with so many brilliant people. I'm overwhelmed, I have to say, by what I've seen and what I've experienced the last few months. It's been very tough, and it's been very joyful, and a real Christian community experience, that's all I can say. And I thank God for this, and thank Jesus. That's all I have to say.
How you doing? down the road. That's
what they call the baby. Come on, Jerry.
Yes, I know. I know those people outside. They're nasty.
Hey, what's that?
Just be
forced
to picture.
I'm just taking my watch out.
Smile, John. Hurry up and get up and button those legs.
Yeah. Carol, go away.
Not me, anyhow.
What do you think?
I'm done. Come out here. Let's go.